The Bournemouth-based department store chain Beales is set to close anytime soon within weeks. The department store chain that was founded in 1881, 139 years ago, will close all of its 23 locations for good, bringing an end of an era to the High Street's history. Now, of course, this is one of the only remaining historic brands to leave the High Street since BHS left in 2016. And of course, this followed with Alders of Croydon in 2012, Woolworths in 2008, and even all the other major shops that have closed down in recent times. The company was established in 1881 and was founded by John Elmes Beale, which he opened a store at the Oriental House on the Old Christchurch Road in Bournemouth. Frank Beale, which was his grandson, was trained at the American rival Macy's in New York City before returning to lead the company. In the 1980s, Nigel Beale, his other grandson of the company's founder, also led the company. It had claimed to be the first department store in the world and would feature a live Father Christmas character dating back to 1885. During the Second World War, the company's Bournemouth store was bombed on the 23rd of May in 1943. The company floated on the London Stock Exchange in 1995. Whittaker's, which was the Bolton department store, opened in 1829 and was bought by Beales in 1996. With the name changed to Beales in 2011. Then the early 21st century came along when they acquired Bentall's department store in Ealing. That store closed in 2007. Tonbridge and Worthing from Fenwick in 2002 also came along. And then their Walton-on-Thames store closed in 2006. A new Beales store opened in Horsham in 2006, which replaced Alders department store. And then in 2010, Beales bought Robb's out in Hexham from the Virgo Retail, which was in administration, for £250,000. In 2010, Beales got stronger again and opened Westgate department store in Rochdale. And then 2011, Beales acquired 19 additional Westgate stores, securing a long-term future. Then in 2012, Beales announced it would be opening an outlet store in Maidstone in the former TJ Hughes store, but sadly that store closed 1 year later due to poor landlords. And in addition, the Skipton branch closed in 2012, and also a branch in Cinderford also closed. In 2014, the Harrogate store closed for redevelopment of the land by the landlord. And then 2016, there was problems going on with Bournemouth. Now, of course, there's three Beales in Dorset. There's Bournemouth, which is their head office. And then there's one in Yeovil. And there's also one in Poole's Dolphin Centre. I've been in the Poole Dolphin Centre store, and of course, I am going to really miss that store so much. And of course, that store also has one of the largest Schindler lifts, which is really big, sizes an airport style. And the branch in Bournemouth, their lifts, they have like details telling you what's on every floor and giving you the opening times. Like on Sunday, it's open from 10:30 till 4:30. And then 2016, a planning application saying they were going to put flats in Bournemouth Beales, but that was then rejected. 2018, Beales expanded to Palmer's. And then the CEO returned after the previous one had health problems. Stuart Lyons, if you remembered in later articles, they were always going on about Beales. And it was going through lots of CVA, like they closed Winchester a long time ago, and Tony Brown returned to the company in 2018. It was a member of the Associated Department Stores, and it enabled Beales to benefit from the cost saving of buying textiles and other non-food goods in bulk. But then 2020, the shop then started to enter administration. On the 12th of January, Beales was warned that the company with 23 stores could collapse into administration if a buyer for the business could not be found. But then on the 20th of January, Beales formally entered in administration and appointed KPMG as the administrators, and it was currently understood that there will be no immediate store closures and Beales stores will continue to trade as normal in the short term. On the same day, the website went offline, so you can no longer go onto the Beales website. And of course, the toy departments were popular, even like I liked toy departments when I was a kid back in Beatty's days, and they used to sell model railways, but now the supply of Hornby's gone independent. They've done it to other shops. So anyway, at the time of entering administration, Beales had 23 stores and employed in excess of 1,000 people whose jobs are at risk, as you can see, I'm reading it off Wikipedia. And on the 7th of February, it was announced Beales will close 12 stores due to failure to sell the chain as a whole. This includes Beales flagship store and many other significant locations. On 18th of February, it was announced that although the negotiations with a number of parties were continuing, the remaining 11 stores would close within following 8 weeks, selling their remaining stock. So this is going to be announced. So all stores will now close. So that is going to bring an end of an era to the High Street's history. So this video is going to show you the photos from what it used to be, from what I had my experience in Beales stores, because I used to love going down to Beales, like I used to go down to Dorset area and go in that lovely department store. But now, you're not going to have any department stores in Poole anymore. You'll only have like the cheaper ones like Marks and Spencer's and Primark and, well, with M&S, they had one in Bournemouth, but that's closed. So Bournemouth, you'll only have Debenhams, House of Fraser, Dingles and Primark. And so you only have Debenhams and House of Fraser now. So this is going to bring an end of an era to Beales department stores. So hope you enjoyed the video, and this is going to probably make you feel heartbroken. Here we go.